Dubai is one of the seven states of United Arab Emirates. It is the most populous city with 2.7 million people. It prides itself with the distinguished seven-star hotel, Burj Arab, and the tallest building in the world, Burj Khalifa. Dubai has 70 shopping centers, and Dubai Mall is the world's largest. The numerous mosques in Dubai belong to the government. Islam is the official religion. Tolerance and freedom of worship to other religions allowed. After landing in Dubai Airport, the group made a two-hour journey to the city of Abu Dhabi. The next morning, they had a half-day city tour, which included a panoramic view of the coast. Their first stop was the Heritage Village. These were some of the exhibits in Heritage Village. And these were some of the shops. A visit to Sheikh Zayed Grand Mosque followed. Sheikh Zayed Grand Mosque is the largest mosque in UAE. It took 11 years to construct between 1996 to 2007. Architectural styles are that of Mughal and Moorish, with 4 minarets, 86 domes and 96 columns. The mosque can accommodate 40,000 people. It has the largest hand-knotted carpet in the world. The mosque is richly inlaid with marble, stone, gold and semi-precious stones, crystals and ceramics. There are 7 imported chandeliers, incorporating millions of Swarovski crystals. The largest chandelier is the 3rd largest in the world. Photo shows the Qurans displayed on the shelves. The following photo shows the exterior surrounding of the mosque. A video presentation follows. We'll be right back. their journey continues, heading towards the date's wholesale market. This was the shop they were persuaded to patronize. They are now crossing over to Yas Island, to Ferrari World Dubai. This is the theme park of Ferrari World. Photo shows them in the mall. This shop shows all the various types of birthstones. After the lunch, the coach headed towards the city of Dubai. Coming up on your right is the tallest building in the world, Burj Khalifa. Note the numerous train stations along the way. This was the hotel they stayed throughout their stay in Dubai. The next morning, a visit to Dubai Museum was made. The museum was built inside the fort and is the oldest existing building in Dubai. Photo shows the dhow outside the fort. Following photos show some of the exhibits in the museum. A stop was made at Oriental World. This is a museum and art gallery, where fine and decorative art were produced. No photography was allowed inside. A visit to Gold Souk followed. Dubai is also known as the City of Gold. The tour continues as it proceeds to the Palm Islands. Video shows the coach traveling along the famous Jumeirah Road, passing rows of offices, retail shops, clinics and mosques. Majority are foreign owned. The coach stopped for a photo shot of Jumeirah Mosque. The coach then proceeded to Jumeirah Beach. This is Jumeirah Beach, with Burj Al Arab in the background. Burj Al Arab is a luxury hotel with 56 floors, shaped like the sail of a ship, built on an artificial island from Jumeirah Beach. A night in the suite cost US$25,000. Thank you.
Here you can view the Wolf in Water Abra and then Qasr 5-star hotel suites are connected to the Madina Souq Jumeirah. We are on the way to the Palm Island now.
We are now crossing over to the Palm Island. We are now proceeding towards Atlantis, the Palm, which is situated on the apex of Palm Jumeirah. Atlantis is the first luxury resort hotel built on the island.
Main entranceway to the lobby of Atlantis.
It has 1,539 rooms.
And to the right from this point you can see 7 million tons of rocks protecting the island from the sea. 7 million tons of rocks. They brought from Fajira Mountains.
Dubai Desert Dunes Safari was next on the agenda in the afternoon. Video shows journey to the desert safari ground. As you can see, the ride on the dunes was rough, especially going up and down the steep ones in the four-wheeler. Some members experienced giddiness during the ride. Duration of the ride was about 45 minutes. Video was taken by Albert, who was sitting at the back of the four-wheeler. Considering the discomfort experienced, I must say it was well taken. This photo shows the desert at sunset. They were entertained with a buffet dinner and performance on the desert ground.
Oh,
The next morning, a stopover was made at Souq Madinat.
Did I just run away if you get a little old? Did you think I don't see that you've given all to me?
A half-day city tour of Dubai building. Followed.
Etisalat building on the right-hand side. That is telling company.
Another visit to the Palm Island
see,
followed.
It has been blessed with the sea, though it was a desert from the earlier days.
Fish.
Yes, lots of marine life, yes, lots of fish, local fish is lots. The famous one is Hamor.
This video shows them returning to the mainland. The coach finally arrived at Dubai Marina.
11:25. Don't you know? I don't care, you're worth so much more to me. I love you as you are. I don't ever want to be set free from you. Ooh. Put your head on my shoulder. Lean a little longer. Put your head on my shoulder and breathe. Put your head on my shoulder. Lean a little longer. Put your head on my shoulder and breathe. Put your head on my shoulder. Lean a little longer. Put your head.
The whole afternoon was spent in Dubai Mall. This video shows live fish swimming in the shop window. Photo shows an advertising display of Dubai Aquarium. This photo shows Dubai fountain and lake. Tickets were purchased to enter Burj Khalifa's observatory tower, which is on the 124th floor. The Burj Khalifa took 5 years to construct, from 2004 to 2009, at a cost of US$1.5 billion. It is 2,700 feet or 828 meters high. It has 163 floors above ground, 46 spiral levels, 2 below ground parking. It took about 1 minute to reach the 124th floor of Burj Khalifa. There was a sandstorm blowing from the desert, which accounted for the hazy photos taken from the glass windows. The view you are seeing is from the observation deck on 124th floor. Ticket for this floor is 200 dirham during peak hours. There There is a higher observation deck on the 148th floor. This is the highest for public viewing. If you wish to view both floors, you have to pay 500 dirham during peak hours. Photo shows the man-made lake and fountain below. You may note part of the city below being lighted up as night falls. In the evening, the group headed towards a river dinner cruise. This photo shows the air-conditioned boat for the Dal Creek dinner cruise.
Prices decided is the water and new water.
There was a party on the top deck of the dam. This was the final stop of the Dal cruise, before heading back. A visit to the famous Miracle Flower Garden was made on the last day of the trip. A buggy took them round the garden.
Oh, better than a wheelchair.
Yeah,
wheelchair go raining.
For sure, I'm going to be manually operated.
Car upside down.
Because this place got nothing.
You can't, are there parrots, the three parrots?
Ah, there are these other fish also.
No, it's not. I can see the fish. I can zoom in from here. Wow, this can spend a fair bit
That's what I say, like, for that money, no problem. The children will love it.
Bring them here.
Thank you, doctor.
A walk round the garden revealed some interesting views. The following are photos of some of the flower exhibits in greater detail. A final stop was made at the Spice Bazaar. Last minute shopping was made before heading home.